around in the back of his pickup cab as well. I'm not sure what that was a moment ago, but we see him driving on the wrong side of the road just a few minutes ago, 80 miles an hour on surface streets like that, extremely dangerous. It must have been stuff moving around in the back.
Hitting about 70 miles an hour, 50 miles an hour right now. JT, we've got about 15 seconds so far.
Yep. Yeah, there was lots of loose stuff in the back of this truck as he continues on Valley Boulevard, approaching 6th Avenue, 50 miles an hour. We are going to be streaming this live on the internet with SkyMap 7, so stay with us on the net as he pulls into a gas station.
All right, we're going to continue to watch the situation. David Muir is coming up with ABC News. We will watch this, and if it continues on, he's going through the car wash right now. If it continues on, we'll have it on KDOC-TV at 7 o'clock as well. We hope you join us.
He's going right under us, dude. You got to move.
All right, JT, we are on online right now, abc7.com.
Approaching Proctor.
Okay. Proctor, there you go. 7th Avenue approaching Proctor. For folks who are joining us right now on abc7.com, I believe JT can hear us. There's that pickup truck making a very aggressive road.
Wrong side of the road here. He's done that several times during this pursuit. On 7th Avenue, approaching Don Julian here, getting into the city of industry, LA County Sheriff's area, but Whittier PD, as we believe, is still the primary in the pursuit. CHP has also been notified as we're continuing here. Southbound on Don Julian, 50 miles an hour right now at 7th Avenue. Wanted for possibly robbery, that's what we're hearing. Robbery suspects driving this white GMC pickup truck, extreme high rates of speed, hitting 90 miles an hour here, going southbound on Don Julian Road. If you're in this area, industry, you're going to want to stay away from this. This thing is going extremely fast, extremely dangerous. Like we said before, he's going through mid-phase red intersections, full tilt, not slowing down, the wrong side of the road, into traffic, very, very dangerous. Robbery suspects to boot, possibly armed. If there are robberies, that's using force or fear, maybe a weapon, as he makes that right turn on Turnbull Canyon Road.
Wow, that is incredible. Yeah, pushing almost 90 miles an hour, JT. I hope you can hear us. We're on ABC7.com right now as we watch this extremely aggressive driver. And keep in mind, this being a white pickup trucks, they have a lot of power, but not necessarily a lot of maneuverability or an ability to stop quickly or turn quickly. So keep that in mind as this guy is pushing 85 miles an hour right now on surface streets in the city of industry. Turnbull Canyon Road, I think, is where he is. 93, 95, 96, almost 100 miles an hour right there, JT.
100 miles an hour on Turnbull Canyon.
Right, and just a heavy pickup truck as well.
Yeah, 100 miles an hour on Turnbull Canyon. That is just amazing speeds here. We're going to widen out just a little bit. We're going to catch up with Air 7HD as he's going south-southwestbound on Turnbull Canyon, right at Los Robles, right through that mid-phase red, nearly striking two vehicles. Luckily, he slowed down to about 30 or 40 miles an hour and didn't go through at that 100 miles. But there he is again, going the wrong side of the road, nearly striking that minivan right behind that white car, right on that tail of that turn. We're on a Vallecito Drive as SkyMap 7 is giving us this information real-time. Real-time speeds as well, coming down Vallecito Road, away from Turnbull Canyon, trying to get around this white sedan. But again, very dangerous pursuit, high speeds. Not sure how many suspects are in the vehicle right now. We know there's obviously the driver, but we haven't seen anybody in the passenger. It looks like there's some dark tint. But there he goes on the wrong side of the road, almost hitting head-on with that vehicle. But just crazy pursuit right now. This suspect definitely does not want to go, and we'll have to see if he's armed or not. But we can't tell. I can't look out the window right now because it's the wrong side. But we're trying to figure out. Well, he makes a left-hand turn on Los Lomitas Drive, and we're in the Hacienda Heights area now. In the LA County Hacienda Heights area, made that left-hand turn. Can't really see if there's a passenger in here, but right through that stop sign, 75 miles an hour, a two-lane highway, two-lane road is Los Mitos. Very small road here, very high speeds. One of the faster pursuits we've seen here in quite a while.
And one of the worst kind of roads that you could be doing this on, a big, large pickup truck at high speeds, you know, two-lane freeways and or highways, rather, and through this residential area as well. Very dangerous time of day to be doing this as well.
Yep, on Tetley Street right now, and just crossed, coming up on Joan Drive, about 63 miles an hour. We're trying to catch up to him right now, trying to get around the airspace. Lots of helicopters around here. But continuing in the eastbound direction, 80 miles an hour. This is just a residential area. You can see the school crossing. Obviously, the school's out by now, but lots of kids probably out, lots of families right out. If you're in the area, Tetley Street in the Hacienda Heights area, stay inside. You don't want your kids, you don't want anybody out right now as he goes near this driveway at Hacienda Boulevard, making that turn onto Hacienda southeastbound. But you want to stay in the house. house right now. Don't come out. Don't try to look at this. It's uncertain where this guy's going to wind up, how fast he's going to go. But by the looks of it, it's very possible he could wreck if he keeps driving like this.
Yeah, we have seen so many accidents when it comes to these reckless drivers with way too much speed flying through intersections. This guy is desperate to get away, a very dangerous driver. I don't know if I've ever seen anybody hitting in the hundreds on surface streets, JT, especially in a vehicle like a pickup truck. This guy is really flying.
40 minutes. Yeah, I'm sorry, David. We were talking to the desk there for a second. I missed your question. I apologize. It was to go southbound on Hacienda Boulevard, topping 60 miles. Go ahead again with your question.
No problem. Not a question. I was just saying, making an observation. I can't recall a pursuit that reached over 100 miles per hour on surface streets before.
Yeah, no, I haven't seen that either, especially the wrong way on surface streets. A lot of freeway speeds, but he's been topping that off. He makes that turn onto Kalima Road here, still on Hacienda Heights. We see there is only the driver as we use extreme vision to get in tight. There is no passenger in there. We thought there might be, but only the driver in here, so that's good information for law enforcement to have as he goes, we'll call it westbound on Kalima Road here, trying to get around traffic aggressively. But, yeah, very high speeds, David. I haven't seen 100-plus going through mid-phase reds and stop signs with very little regard for public safety at all.
Right, boxed in right now. It's good to see those cars get out of the way as soon as they can. They must see a big white pickup truck, you know, at that high rate of speed. Just to get out of the way is a good idea.
Yeah, absolutely. Again, in being a robbery suspect, we're still trying to gather the details on the nature of the robbery, but use force or fear, possibly a weapon. That's what we're getting from the original agency in pursuit of the suspect, the Whittier Police Department. You can see LA County Sheriff's helicopter, Aero Bureau overhead, weather helicopter tracking and calling this pursuit and letting these agencies know as we get back into the Whittier area on Kalima Road, moving southwestbound, that he is coming into their area, and keep them advised.
All right, we're going to continue to watch this. We are on ABC7.com. Obviously, we're going to pick this up. If it continues to go at 7 o'clock, we'll be on KDOC-TV. 101 miles an hour just hit there, JT. This guy is really flying, and you could see him actually make a little bit of air over a bump he hit. I'm so concerned if he has intersections coming up, because you know he's going to try to fly right through those.
Yeah, it's hard to tell actually how fast he's going because we're so tight, but we're going to pull out a little bit wider to slow down a little bit just to give you some perspective on how fast he's actually going here. Well, it looks like he might be turning into this area here as we push back in. It's a little turnout area off of Kalima Road in the 7500 block of Kalima Road in Whittier. Almost looks like a rest stop. We're going to watch to see the suspect bails out. He does not try to get around that other pickup truck, just squeezes through there. I'm not really sure what this area is here, maybe a hiking trail of some sort. Do you see some department, maybe Whittier, I'm not sure, drive right by. Now he's behind the Whittier officers. Yeah. They're uncertain where he went, but he's going to go right by them there on Kalima Road, right at Marvissa Street, and that is Whittier PD picking the pursuit back up, and here are the speeds again. I'm not sure. We didn't see any units directly behind him as he's continuing southwestbound here, and maybe he thought he could duck out and try to hide from those pursuing officers to see if he can maybe pull an okey-doke on him, but obviously LA Sheriff's Department Aero Bureau is not going to let that happen and was able to get them back on their pursuit.
Right.
He certainly had a lot of close calls as he's passing these cars and going on the wrong side of the road and just swiping by. But fortunately, so far, no hits, but it's been very close.
Got it. Yeah, we're getting information now, guys, that originally there were two suspects in the truck at some point during the pursuit. The passenger suspect got out of the car, and I'm not sure if he's in custody or not, but he was arrested. We understand that he was taken in custody and arrested, so that is good to have. At least they can talk to that suspect, maybe get information on who this guy is, where he's going, what he's up to, maybe try to contact him. But there we are again, 100 miles an hour, close to it, right at Kalima Road. We're going right through that red light. What are you nearly taking out that SUV, the rear end of that SUV going through, making that left turn? That would have been catastrophic as we're going continuing southbound on Kalima Road at Jupiter Street. Just scary, scary. Robbery suspect, high-speed pursuit, Whittier PD along with Sheriff's Department trying to get this guy as we go through the heart of Whittier.
Now, in case folks are not familiar with our SkyMap 7, it is an invaluable tool when it comes to watching these pursuits. You could see the miles per hour right there in the middle of your screen, the green numbers that you see. That is tracking real-time on the speed of this vehicle as he tries to maneuver his way through these dangerous turns. So there are some tools here, but that is an invaluable one when it comes to SkyMap 7, offering us some information when it comes to how fast these guys are going. In this case, this man We've seen them go as high as 103 miles per hour on surface streets. JT.
Yeah, we just caught, this is Anaconda Street right off Chesley, in a residential area, very beautiful trees in the area, kind of hard to see in these purple trees. So we're looking off our left here, Brendan, so we're going to see where he goes here, making on Paris, now he's still on Anaconda, just crossed Paris Drive, the 14,600 block, coming back out to what looks like Mills Avenue. We'll see which way direction he goes. Yeah, try to lose officers in that residential area. A lot of times we'll see this, they're trying to get out of those officers' eye line, maybe bail in residential areas. We're shooting off to the left and rear here, so we're coming around left. As we're on Mills Avenue westbound at 60 miles an hour, again, when he got on those residential speeds, still very high speeds, a lot of kids, a lot of families out there in that beautiful neighborhood we saw, just a scary stuff. You want to stay inside. If anybody's hearing this and you know anybody that lives in Whittier, this area, keep them inside here as we're continuing on Mills, right at Lambert Road, going southbound. And now we're in South Whittier. Just crossed over into South Whittier here, continuing south on westbound, I should say, on Mills Avenue here. Stay inside. Don't come out to watch this. Watch it on ABC7.com, and we'll keep you informed.
Certainly. And JT, he started in Whittier, then went over to Hacienda Heights. Is he seems like he's back circling back to where he began?
Yeah, it started in Whittier, went into the LA County area, and then it came back into Whittier and now South Whittier here. Speed slowing down, so it looks like he may be making a turn here, looking for somewhere to duck out. We're not going to go too wide right now. On Mills, crossing onto Mulberry Street. This is westbound Mulberry Street from Mills. Again, speeds about 30 miles an hour. He's trying to get as much, wow, nearly clipped the back end of that pickup truck there. Trying to get away from officers, trying to get out of their eye line. But you can see LA County Sheriff's arrow bureau right overhead. He's not going to get away from them. Coming to a stop here, slowing down at Gun Avenue from Mulberry, making that northbound turn on Mulberry. At least the good news, slowing down a little bit, at least for the time being. But continuing northbound on Gun Avenue here in South Whittier.
Yeah, he seems to be wandering. I wonder if he knows where he's going right now. And when he went into that little, what looked like some sort of a rest point, I'm wondering if he was looking for a place to possibly bail out and start running. That would be a good choice compared to what we're seeing here. And he's
not
right.
Good.
Okay, here we go.
Not good here. Officer's drawing down. He stopped right in front of the suspect. It seemed he's on Gun and Landing. It seemed like he wanted to stop in front of that officer for some reason. A very scary motive. You think he's trying to get away from officers, but it looked like he intentionally slowed down and stopped in front of that officer, causing that officer to open up his door, draw his service weapon, and try to prone the suspect out. Very scary situation there. Uncertain why the suspect kind of made a run at that officer there.
I wonder if he was contemplating taking a right there where the officer was, thinking he could leave the officer behind him. But then that would have been really dangerous. That officer would have to make a tough decision, JT.
Yeah, luckily the suspect pulled off. If he had made any overt movement towards the officer, if the officer didn't have an option to get away, he may have been forced to shoot that suspect. That's something that would have been a very unfortunate situation here. But now they're on Lambert Road. We're working back northwestbound on Lambert. The speeds have slowed down. Suspect we've noticed from Air 7 HD, Rob Gluckman with Extreme Vision on the controls of Extreme Vision camera, saw that the suspect is on the cell phone, and now he's slowed down a little bit, which is interesting.
Yeah.
Going from 100 miles an hour and slowing down here on Lambert, approaching Coachman.
Also driving with his hazard lights on. I'm not sure if he's aware of that or who knows.
Which is ridiculous when you think about these things, but still, I guess it's an effort.
Yep. So it looks like the guys were hearing that the department, Whittier PD, is going back into what they call surveillance or tracking mode. That means they're going to back off a little bit, let the air unit call the pursuit. There is a supervisor, and I often say this, there's a supervisor that's in charge of managing this pursuit, doing what's called the balance dance, constantly balancing what is the importance of taking the suspect into custody against anybody getting hurt, whether it be officers or the general public at large, making sure that no one gets hurt. That's his job right now. What pursuit intervention techniques to use or tactics to use, when to re-engage the pursuit. They have backed off. They're letting LA Sheriff's Department Aero Bureau call the pursuit, which they're doing right now, letting them know every move he makes, just like we're doing here in Air 7 HG, the direction, the speed, where he's at, and getting them all the information. Now, if that suspect decides to pull over and bail and run, well, they're going to swoop in with multiple officers, set up a containment or a perimeter around that suspect, try to get him locked into that. And if he goes to ground or tries to hide in a bush or something, they're going to get those canine units out there and try to take him into custody. But right now, he's slowed down, so that's good news. It appears like the surveillance tactic is working right now. But you got to remember, this is a robbery suspect, so he's possibly armed. The last thing we want to do here is we don't want that suspect to try to carjack another vehicle here.
At least he's slowing down. It makes it for a little bit safer situation. But now, this is kind of a...
Slowing down, but still running through
right.
these intersections
exactly.
in a dangerous yep. way. But at least he's not going 80, 90, 100 miles per hour, which was extremely scary. Go ahead, JT.
Oh, sorry, David. We are now northeastbound on Santa Fe Springs Road. Now, we did see, we're going to pull out a little bit, Rob, to show that black and white. There is a black and white in right behind him. Now, he doesn't have his emergency lights on, but they are close enough to be in pursuit and re-engage this pursuit, at least three or four units behind them. But it does not look like their emergency equipment is engaged. Their lights and their siren are not on right now. So technically, they are not in pursuit. They are just tracking. And they are in surveillance. But now we're slowing down here. We're in the 8100 block of Santa Fe Springs Road in Whittier, slowing down, uncertain if the vehicle has become disabled. We did not see a spike strip laid down at all.
No.
So uncertain why he's slowing down, but is slowing down here at Santa Fe Springs Road in Cullen. Maybe running out of gas. We often see this when the vehicle starts to become run out of gas. They slow down. Look at that left hand. Let's see if we can't get in with extreme vision and get a close look at the suspect. Looks like he is left hand. Maybe some tattoos on there, white t-shirt, a red ball cap maybe, making that right turn onto Washington Boulevard. Well, hold on, not so soon. Slowing down through that intersection right at Whittier Boulevard and Santa Fe Springs. Not really sure what he's doing. Let's get a closer look in there, Rob. Get a real close look here. Maybe we can get a better description.
Yeah.
On the cell phone, tattooed,
yeah.
Red hat. Looks like he's maybe has some tattoos or a dirty left arm. Lots of stuff rolling around in that truck, and it's a GMC Sierra truck that we can see with extreme vision. Trying to explain to someone, uncertain if he's talking to the police department, maybe some family members, trying to maybe negotiate a place to surrender. Hopefully that's the case. But the good news is he slowed down. No more 100-mile-an-hour speeds here.
Yeah, maybe he's getting the message.
Yeah, apparently we just weren't told by the desk that he is speaking with the police department.
Okay.
So that is good news. Maybe possibly the suspect in custody gave them the driver's name and a cell phone number so they're able to talk to him. Whatever it is, it's working. That's really good news for the police right now that he slowed down.
Right. And, he was going 100 miles per hour on surface streets, and he couldn't shake anybody. Has a helicopter overhead, a line of police cars behind him. So maybe he's figuring out that he's not going to be able to get away. They're going to stay on top of him, and that there's no sense in putting his life in danger and everybody else's life in danger.
Yeah, I mean, that would be the reasonable thing to do, and sometimes it takes someone with some negotiation skills on the department that can say, listen, you know what, you're wanted for robbery, that's a bad thing, but if you kill somebody in this pursuit, that's a whole different rap. You're not going to want to face that. That is, we're getting a little steep here, Brandon, we're going to slide away. That's a whole different thing. So maybe getting him to slow down like that, let's just talk this over, find a place to surrender, we'll work it out. Telling him whatever he wants to hear, to be quite honest, that's all they need to do to get him into custody and to stop this madness so no one gets hurt.
All right, so we are continuing to watch him as he talks to the police, and hopefully they'll be successful. They have been successful in getting him to slow down, way down. He is basically behind those large trees on that street right there in Whittier with a large behind him. And by the way, Colleen Sullivan is taking place of Ellen Leyva as we prepare to go on the air on KDOC TV for Eyewitness News.
Yeah, David, we've been watching this high-speed pursuit now taking place for over a half hour or so. We saw it at the end of your Eyewitness News at 6, but this robbery suspect really taking some chances and driving really quickly. But now I just noticed is that he's sort of coming to almost a stop, JT.
Yeah, it looks like he stopped here on Pickering Avenue, the 7600 block, right at Mar Vista. We'll see what he does here. We're going to try to get angle. Lots of tall pine trees lining Pickering Avenue here. This is a real good spot right here, Brandon, if we can hold it here. On the phone, maybe we can pull out a little bit, Rob, to see if we can't...
He stuck his hand. He keeps sticking his hand out the window, JT, but I couldn't see if he was dropping anything or doing anything.
Yeah, it looks like he just threw something out the window, maybe the keys, hoping it's the keys. We're going to push just a little forward here so we can get a good line of sight because it looks like he may be not sure if that was the keys or possibly some contraband or evidence. We could come out of sky map here to see what he's doing. uncertain if the vehicle has become disabled. Maybe, yeah, I understand that. Thanks, got that. So we're going to see if he comes out of the vehicle right now, the keys, I'm not sure if that was a keys out the left side. You see that red thing off the right side? That's what he threw out the window. Uncertain if that's a keychain or a lighter or something else, but the good news is he is stopped here. Watch your drifter. We're going to come out this way a little bit. But right now, police right behind him. And this is what we call a high-risk felony stop. Whittier PD, at least four or five deep, trying to get him proned out. Lots of weapons on the suspect. A suspect's door is open right now, still on the cell phone. We're going to watch his hands right now. We're going to use extreme vision here, Rob, to get in real tight, just to watch his hands for a second to see. The keys are coming out. Those are the keys in his left hand. Phone's in his right hand. That's good news. So both his hands are occupied with something here. We're going to widen out just a little bit. He's throwing the keys on the ground, still on the phone. Hand, one hand is up. They're going to make him throw that cell phone. Now we're going to push a little bit forward to get rid of that pine tree branch here. Try to get that out of your shot. Right now what happened is Whittier PD is giving him commands with a PA system. Put your hands up. We're going to hold right here, maybe a little steeper. And put your hands up. Come back to the sound of my voice. But he's on the phone. He's on the phone with apparently we're being told dispatch right now that right now we just want him to throw the phone down is what they're saying. Put the phone down and prone yourself out. That's what he's doing right now, getting that message. Sometimes some officers, it depends on the tactics of the department, some will have them raise their shirts to show the waistband, maybe do a 360-degree turn. But yeah, that's not good. Reaching behind him like that in the waistband area is usually not something we see. Maybe a tactic that Whittier PD does, but I'm not so sure that that is a good thing to do. So we're just going to widen out just a little bit because we're not sure what the suspect's actions are going to be. Okay, now both hands are back up. That's a good thing. But we want to make sure that if he makes any overt movements towards the suspect, that's not a good thing, and it could end very badly here, and we don't want to put that out. But we're going to now the hands on the head. A lot of confusing commands for this suspect. Not really acting rationally. Looks confused. Not really sure what to do left and right. Very interesting situation here, but we'll see how this plays out, David.
Yeah, it is interesting. He does seem confused, and I'm worried. Okay, now that's standard procedure, right, JT?
Yep. Yeah, exposing the waistband, putting the shirt up so they can see the waistband. It's not unusual for them to have him do a 360-degree turn so they can see his front waistband, which is what he's doing right now, but they usually want him to keep the shirt up when he does that, so it didn't quite work out. But we could see from our shot here, it appeared that his waistband was clear in the front. Mm-hmm. Now they're giving him the commands. Walk back towards the sound of our voice using the PA system in the black and whites, and walking backwards to the sound of my voice, and that's exactly what they're doing. We'll see if they prone him out on the concrete or the street area in front of the police cars, or maybe even walk him back to all the way back to the cars. Every agency has a little bit different tactics on what they do, and it even differs from officer to officer based on their training and their experience and what they're comfortable doing, or even the supervisor at scene who's orchestrating this entire process right now. So as soon as they get hands on him, get him into custody, they'll go send a team to clear that car. What I mean is clear is make sure there's no additional suspects or anything in there.
Looks like
the suspect's having a hard time proning himself out here, but he is proning himself out. Down to one knee, he'll come out to the ground. We'll put both hands out front of him. He'll put his hands out to his side, his feet out as far as he can. Spread your legs, I'll say. Bury your heels. And then they'll come up and take him into custody with the team. But he's moving very slow. It almost looks like he's sore or something weird.
Yeah, it looks like he has some sort of injury on his leg, at least on his right leg maybe. It was very hard for him to get down onto his knees. So one never knows. But taking his hat off. And, yeah, he does seem like he's going slowly. And he's very somewhat confused. Maybe there are several different people telling him calls? I don't know.
Yeah, usually they have one person doing it, but it's not unusual that maybe another person may be shouting commands. But it looks like he's hooked up right now in cuffs. Now they'll get that team together and take clear that truck, make sure there's no additional suspects in there. From our vantage point, it doesn't appear to be so. It is just a single cab, so there's no back seat or very small back seat. Doesn't look like there's anybody in there. But suspect is in custody right now doing a primary search, make sure there's no weapons anywhere on the suspect's person.
All this going on while there's somebody sitting in that red van right there. I guess he was in the wrong place at the right at the wrong time, but at least it's ending peacefully, JT.
Yeah, he was right on Pickering when this thing terminated, and all I can say is just an amazing job by the police department to get him to slow down and stop. They'll clear the car, and this one ended very peacefully, and it's a good thing that it did.
Okay, as they approach the pickup truck, they're going to give it one last check, but this pretty much is wrapped up. So what we're going to do is we'll prepare an update for you at 7 o'clock on KDOC TV. That's coming up in just about 7 minutes from right now. We hope you join us.